Today I will present you the multi-charger battery tester version 3. If you see my other video, I know you wait this moment for a long time. I'm sorry for that. If you don't still watch the series, version 1 was 32 cells, constant load discharger. Version 2 was 30 cells, constant current discharger. And this one here, it's version 3. These have only 60 cells, but don't be disappointed. He run faster, better, with more option, and it's more simple to build it. It's a simple design. This little guy can charge up to 1 amps, also can discharge up to 2 amps. But have two discharging modes, constant loads and constant current. He also have temperature monitor for each cells on a entire process. Have a monitor of voltage on a charge and also on discharging. He can calculate the capacity of the discharging cell, the capacity of the battery. Also can calculate the charging capacity, how much energy you put in the cell. Also have an internal resistor for the battery, internal resistor test, and also automatically detect the faulty cells. So if you are interested, watch the video, and you can build this little guy yourself. So let's explain you how this guy work. We have 16 slots, but we have only 8 charging and only 8 discharging, so less components. But the is twice faster. Why? Because we use a dual relay to change the battery from charging to discharging port, and the port working the same time. If you see here, the red lights means this battery are discharging, also that and also that, and the red and the green one means that is charging. So if you see this port, it's the pair of that. This is charging, this is discharging. If you see this is already discharged. You can see it's in low state, so it's discharged. It have 1173 amps, so it's the discharging test, it's made. He wait this battery to be charged and to swap to charge. So that's why in this moment this battery do nothing, because discharging it's made and wait to charge port to be swapped. In same time here, this is discharging, this is charging. So he don't need one battery, don't need to wait the entire process to be completed. One phase of the process it's completed, the battery are swapped between. So this is completed discharge, will be swapped when this will be charged. So the hardware, it's less hardware, less money put it in the hardware, and twice faster. You see here, all the blue light means the battery are in some kind of waiting state for something to happen. So like, see, this is charging. That one, he wait to be charged. So when it's be the green one here done, will be swapped. Also, let's see, we have the voltage. In the first version and the second version, we cannot read the voltage when it's charged. Also, we don't read the current. So now we can do that. We have some current sensor on charging mode. So now this cell is charged 190 milliamps. This is total capacity, put it here, the time. Also I have the temperature of this cell. So also we can track all the temperature of the cell through the charging and discharge process, and if the temperature is increased above some limit, automatically the charge and discharge it's stop. Let's look also on this discharging cell like that. This will be the number 7. Okay, this is charging. Okay, here is the number 7. Also, you can see the temperature is a little higher than the charging. Here it was 28 of grids, here is 30 grids because on discharging this is a little hotter. This is the amount of energy discharged tested until now. The time have two minutes when process start. Also, here we have the amperage. If you see, this is in constant current. I discharge it with 1 amps. It's around 1 amps because the tester will try to take from the battery only 1 amps, but will be a little more or little less. It'll be 1998 or 1023, like that. Like I see it now, it's changing a little bit. It's 1986, but overall it will be 1 amps on entire process. Here also we have the temperature. Here also have the live voltage. One other thing very important for this tracker, all the data are sent to the internet. I use a serial to Wi-Fi ACP converter. So for this reason I don't use a larger screen, because all the data I need, all the programming I need to do it, will do it from the PC. I don't need to see it here to stay to take the data from the display. That's why I used a smaller display. It's cheaper and it's better. So about the temperature reading, all the cell have a temperature sensor, one wire, DS80S20. All the temperature is read by one single digital pin. After the cycle is complete, the charging, discharging, and also the recharging, if you want to do it, the blue light will disappear. So you'll know this cell can be go out and can put another cell in this place. Also, if you take out in any time a cell, the process will be automatically stop. Like that, you will see the blue light, it's gone. Now, if I put another battery in the place, the process will go from beginning. So this cell will wait first to be charged and to be discharged, and also so on. I will show you a little bit the control. It's like a monster, because I use prototyping board, and all the wiring and connection are removable with screw one. So we'll see. First look, it's a little bit horror, but I will show you. So this is how it look. Yeah, it's put it on stage. I have here the relay board. Here I have the discharging. You can see the discharging resistor, also the discharging MOSFETs, the charging boards. These are the slots with the temperature for the battery. Also here you can see the controller, the mega controller. Also the display boards, and also the current sensors. A lot of wires. If you look first time, it can be a little scary to see so much wires here, but you can build it more compact if you use already plugged wire, if you sold your wire. Also, here I have two fans on each part to cooling my resistors for the charging, and I will show you more when I dismount this. For you, I will dismount the parts, and I will show you each component, and I explain what will do each component for you.